This lecture I'll cover just some key concepts on rotational and translational motion. These are important for problem solving. Let us take a disk. You can take a sphere also. I'm taking a disk of radius r and it is moving like this. It has certain velocity v and it is having pure rolling. Now in such motions we say it is rotational and translational. So two things you have to keep in mind. When you say rotational and translational, you are saying rotational motion as far as its rotation about center of mass is concerned. So we are talking about rotation about center of mass. And when we say translational motion means that we are talking about velocity of center of mass in K frame, non-inertial frame we have taken. So these two things have to be kept in mind. Now when you say rotational and translational, simply if you have to find out the kinetic energy, you add the kinetic energy of rotational, and I'll show you something very interesting now. Now kinetic energy is a rotational and translational. When we write, it is half m v square plus what is the rotational kinetic energy, half I is m r square upon 2 in case of disk and omega square is, omega is nothing but v upon r whole square, so it becomes half m r square upon 2 m square upon 2 v square. So finally you get half mv square as common into 1 plus 1 upon 2. Why I have written in this form is, you see interesting thing now. So when you have to write the kinetic energy of both the rotational and translational motion, first of all don't get confused what velocity you have to take. You have to take velocity of only the center of mass and rotation about the center of mass. And simply you write like this, half. Combined formula you can write like this, because in exam every time if you do that there is a chance of mistake in calculation. To avoid that, just follow this approach. Half mv square you write, bracket 1 plus c. C is nothing but the coefficient which is with mr square for the moment of inertia. Like in case of ring, c is 1. Let me write moment of inertia. Ring is mr square, disk is mr square upon 2, shell is 2 upon 3 mr square, and it is 2 upon 5 mr square. Likewise you can write for sphere. So c is something which is there with mr square. So here it is 1 upon 2, here it is 1, it is 2 upon 3, it is 2 upon 5. Just put this c here in this formula. So kinetic energy remains half mv square into 1 plus c. When there is no rotation, C is zero. That is pure translational motion. Now one more interesting thing I'll tell. Suppose I take moment of inertia about this point. That is the instantaneous axis of rotation. Whole body is rotating about this axis. We call it as instantaneous axis of rotation. And it is omega only. It is rotating. The omega remains same, it doesn't change with the change in axis. So if I find moment of inertia about this point, instantaneous axis of rotation, moment of inertia is what? Half mr square is the moment of inertia about center of mass, perpendicular distance is r, so plus mr square, so this 3 upon 2 mr square. If you multiply the omega, means if you take this as the reference point and you take kinetic energy as a rotation about this axis, which is half I omega square. What is I? Is 1 upon 2 into 3 upon 2 mr square omega square. It is 3 upon 4 mr square omega square, or it is 3 upon 4 mv square. And here what was coming? It was half mv square 1 plus 1 upon 2, because c is 1 upon 2 here, so it is mv square upon 2, 3 upon 2, it is 3 upon 4 mv square. So if you happen to take moment of inertia at a point of contact in such kind of motion, then if you take rotation about instantaneous axis of rotation, then you don't have to take the translational motion. That is what I wanted to tell. Because if you do this and then also add half mv square, it'd be wrong. So either you follow this practice or you follow this practice, result will be same, but you should be very clear in your mind. Very, very clear that moment you take moment of inertia at the axis of rotation, this translational motion of center of mass, kinetic energy, is not to be taken with that, because that has already been accounted in this formula.